Hi and welcome to C# tutorial of Windows 10 calculator style. Let me just show you guys how this works. Alright, so you enter whatever number you want in there. Let's say multiply by 9. There we go. Okay, and if you notice there's a bin there. You click on that bin, we get this message back. And if we decide to add some values, you see the message is gone. Okay, so we can just carry that on all day, and that is what you get. Okay, just like the Windows 10 calculator style, right? So the other thing that we have in here is we can also go for that, right? And we can even select any other calculation method that we want in here. But the problem is it's not completed yet. I expect to get an encouraging amount of view here, say 30,000 and 1,000 like. That would be very nice to continue with the rest implementation. So, well, what I would do now is I'm going to take you guys straight into C# development environment, and let's put one of these together. So let's do that now. And welcome back to C#. Now I'm going to click on create new project. Now the dialog box is ready, let's select C# right there and select Windows Farm. Let's give it a name. I'm going to call it CS_Windows_10_calculator. So that will be the name of my project. Click on OK. Now that the dialog box is ready, the form is ready, so let's change the form size to, let's go for maximum. So I'm going to go for 789 by 690, and I'll then enter minimum size here. Let's go for 420 by 690 as well, and maximum would be the same size here, so that would be 700 plus 789 by 690. There. Now the next thing I want to do is let me add a button. This button I'm gonna need approximately 24 of those. So first thing first, let's check out the size. I want it to be 90 by 69, and let's change the font size. Let's change that to approximately, let's, that'll be 20. Good. And we also need to change the interface. Let me change that here to flat, and flat appearance I'm going to change that. Let's get rid of that and make that 0. Okay, so which means we might not be able to see it, so let's come in here and change, let's change this to button face. Okay, maybe we should, let's change it to something Gainsborough. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, that's a bit much better. I will leave this as, let's change this control to button face. That's fine. So I need 24 of those. So I'm going to click on it, hold down the control and drag. We need 24 of those. So let's speed up the whole process of this button. There we go, guys. This is how my interface is looking like, because it's going to take some time, so I just have to speed that up. The next thing I want to do is, let me go straight to the tools here and grab rich text box. We need this rich text box right here. There. Okay. And right underneath here, I'm going to need a button as well. Let's come in here for a button. And that very button, I will then go into Microsoft Word and copy anything that looks like a bucket. And right here, that's the bucket that I intend to use. I've actually copied it from Word documents. Okay, most of the stuff that I'm using are right here. Okay, I'm going to need this as well. Let me just copy that now. Copy. And maybe we add a label there. Let's come right here and just get a label and come right down here and paste that in there. Right, that's there, and just let's increase the font size of that to something a little bit more readable. Let's go for maybe 24. Right, that's fine. Paste that right there. I'm still gonna copy that label. And that same label, let's change the content in there to, let's change that to standard. Right, that seems a little bit too big. Alright, I'm going to change this, the font of that label, let's change that to 16k. Let's go for 16. Right, and let's copy it across. I need to here, control and copy, 1, 2 and one here, and then I need one here. There's going to be one here. All right, so this one is going to be history. So let's come in here, enter history in there. And the other one, this will be memory. And in here, this there is no, I think is there's no history yet, something like that. No history yet. Yeah, something like that. And in here, let's give this a name. I'm going to call that LBL. Say maybe. So we call it LBL show operator. Right. That's the name of that. And let's come in right here and get rid of whatever content is in there for now. Yeah, that has to go anyway. It's not for now. Then the next thing is, let's grab a text box. Right, one text box here. Let's paste that in here. Grab it down more, change this to multi-line. And change the content in there to maybe 36. Yeah, 36. And align right, make that zero there, and give it a name. I'm going to change it to TXT display. Right, so that should align with this. Where is it? Right there. Let's move it here a little bit. Right. Okay, now the next thing is we need to change the back color of these two button face. Back color here. That'll become button. Where is it? Okay, let me just type it up. Button face. Right there. And change the border style from fixed to none. Right. That is how it is in the latest calculator. Alright, that's done. This one, let's change it to button face as well. The back color. it's easier to type it. Button face, and the style will become none right there, but I'm aware there's something there. Okay, I have my button, I have everything there. Okay, let's start with the coding. I'll start by declaring some variables. Just click on the form right underneath here, right underneath public class. So let's enter double result equals 0. Now the next thing is going to be, let me declare a string operator. Let's use lowercase operator operations equals, there's nothing in there. Then boolean, I'm gonna call it enter value equals false. Right, let's enter semicolon there. Then the next thing that I'd like to declare is, I think I should declare a char I operator or operation. Yeah, done. Now that I have all my variables in place, let's go back to the form. I'm going to select all of these buttons from button 7 right down here, apart from this very one. Okay, and let's come in here, you see where it says events, click on the event, and let's go to click event. Maybe I should give it a name, numbers underscore only. Right, press enter. Okay, the first thing I'll do is I'm going to declare or create an object there. Let's create object button. Let's say number or B, let's just call it B, equals, let's say button sender. That is my object created. The object is known as object B. Okay, for object B, I want it to do as follows. So let's go for, let's say, if B, okay, let's go for the text box first. If txt display dot text equals 0, that should be in a speech mark. Or my entry, so entry value and txt display dot text equals clear. Why entry itself becomes, or enter value becomes false. Right. So that's the first one. Okay, let's sort this out. There should be a bracket there. Okay, that's fine. Then the next one is, let's use an else if. Oh, let's go for, let's say, if b.text, that's just to check if there's any decimal points in there. Okay, if it contains any decimal place, what I want would like it to do, it will be as follows. Okay, right in here, let's go for if not text box txt display dot text dot contains a decimal point, then txt display, copy that, txt display space to right here equals txt display plus b dot text right there. Yeah, okay. Else let's say txt display and do that. Let's copy this there. All right, so let's see what's going to happen if I run it. Okay, let's run it first. Looks all right to me, because if there's zero in there and this value equals, this value should be false, and clear this. And if there's a dot decimal point, okay, if not, we insert one. All right, else we just enter whatever numbers, whatever is selected. So let's run it and see. Okay, there we go, guys. So let's try out the buttons. Yeah, that's fine. Decimal place, 3. Let's put another one. See, that's fine. It's working. That's good. All right, clear is now working yet. None of this works yet. All right then. So let's continue. That's good. So have a good look at those lines of code that I used an event to put together. There they are. Okay, that's the object created, and that object represents all the content on the buttons. Okay, now let's come back in here. The next thing I would like to do is, you see this, I'm going to group them together and come right here, enter click event as well. Yeah, so that's going to be arithmetic operations. Arithmetic or let's say operator, click operator underscore click operators, press enter. Right inside operator underscore click, I'm going to also create an object. So let's copy the object up there and bring it right in there. Okay, so now I need as follows. The operation that I declared up there equals b.text, and in that case the result equals whatever is in the text box. So let's say double dot parse whatever we have inside txt display dot text there. So what's happening here is, when I click on that very button, B represent the button, whatever is on that very button is stored inside the operator. Okay, And if it's, if I press any number, that number is then stored inside result, the variable result. Remember all my variables that are up there: result, operation, I operator, and enter value. Okay, so let's continue. Now the next thing is, in that case, let's clear our txt display, and whatever is inside txt display should go into the operator, LBL operator that I declared, equals clear. Right. Now, if you guys can still recall, this very one up here is not visible. It's right here. That's it. The name is called, it is called LBL show operator, show ops. Let's call it show ops with an S. Show whatever operator that is used. I'm gonna copy that now. And come right in here. Come back in here. Paste that in there. Show ops dot text equals, let's say, system dot convert. Convert it to string dot to string. And what are we converting? Whatever we have inside result, that's what we're converting. Let's say plus and add a space there. Plus another operation. Add the operation that has been selected. So the number is added onto LBL operators ops, and the operation selected is added as well. That's what I've just entered in there. Okay, so let's see if I give it a try and see what's gonna happen with this up. If I press any of these and select that, look at that, that works. That's good. So it seems to be too much space, and I also need to move this back in a little bit. Yeah, let's try it again. Six. That is good. All right. Okay, but there's going to be a problem, because let's say we decide to save 45 multiplied by 6 plus 3, we're going to end up with nothing there. The answer would end up becoming 9. So to get that sorted, right here where we have the operator, we need to modify the operator. And that is supposing the result is not equals to, it's not equals to 0. So I would like the system, let's say btn equals dot perform. I like it to perform an operator or operation that's already performed in on the equals itself. So let's say enter value. In this case, will become true right there. Then the data inside the operator, the data on the bottom is this stored on the operator. Okay, and at the same time, we just need to add those information onto our show ops. Right, so that is if is clicked, the any button is clicked more than once or twice. Else, you should just perform the following. There, just close that there. And that should take care of that very problem there. Now, let's take care of equals. or declare. Let me have a look at declare anyway. I don't think there are names on them. So let's give them all a name. Properties. All right, let's double click on this. And in there, all we just need to enter is going to be display.text equals zero. So where is it again? Double click. There we go. Equals zero. There. And the other one. Becomes that, and the result, let's say result equals zero. That's it. Clear is taken care of. Now let's have a good look at the equals, this very button here. Okay, so with the equals, first thing I'd like to do is to clear out whatever content we have in here. That's how the Microsoft operate. Clear it out. Then using the switch statement, let's say our operator. No, I called it operation. Operation, let's say switch, right, wrong spelling, right. Then I'm going to start with, let's say the case we're dealing with now is the plus sign. Let's enter plus. Okay, and there'll be a column there. Then that means display txt display equals whatever is inside the result plus. Let's say double dot pass whatever I have inside txt display, and because the value now is going to be in string format, I have to convert it. So there I'll say dot convert the string, and then we block our, we break our first case. So all I just need to do now is copy all of this. Right, so this will be for subtraction, and change that to subtract, maybe multiplication, change that to multiplication sign. This would be for maybe division. Change this to division. Right. That's taken care of. Or maybe we should even change this sign, let it look the way it looks on the system. I'm gonna change it. Something like that. So that means the case will become this. Let's hope that will work. The other thing we need to do is, let's set a default there. Default dot break. Right. Then underneath here, let's say result equals. Result equals that, result equals double dot plus the txt display. So let's clear the operator. In that case, we have to clear this. Whatever we have in there should be cleared. Right. Equals cleared. All right. Okay, before we run this, let's take care of backspace. So with the backspace, we enter as follows. These are the lines of code for the backspace. So I'm going to give it a try. Let's see what's going to happen. And let's give it a try. Let's say 41 multiply by 6 plus 3 plus, that is correct, 2 plus 9 multiply by 4, that is fine. Okay, you guys see that that's how I want it to work. So that's brilliant. Now let's take care of our memory right here. If you guys can still recall, we have, there we go, we have the memory right in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure everything, or I'm going to make everything work within this equals. All right guys, before we can take care of this, let's do something. Let's come into operator here, and we can't even do nothing until we're going to declare some variable. I'm going to change this. Let's change that, because I'm not going to be using it. Let's change it to maybe Q, or shall we go for first number, comma, and second number. Right, so those two I'm going to be using. The first one, let me assign some values into the first string here. Let's come straight in here inside these operators, come right down right underneath here. Let's say first equals LBL show operator. Right, that's all you need to enter in there. So whatever we have in here is stored right in here. Now we then go straight into the equals, because when we click on the equals, we want everything, all of the calculation that has taken place, to be displayed here. So let's double click on the equals. I'm going to enter that right underneath here. Maybe we should even enter a break there. All right, so right underneath here, let's say if there's anything in there, let it get cleared first. That's it. BTN clear history dot visible. Let's make it visible anyway, and then equals true. Now what about, let's say RTB display dot append. And what I would like it to append would be whatever value I have inside one, inside first number. Instead of entering this, let's enter first number plus, let's enter a speech mark there, and plus whatever I have inside second number plus, let's say plus equals, let's add another plus in there, and that will be, give me a new line. Yeah. Right. But this second number, I haven't added any value into that, so I'm gonna copy that second number so that I don't get it mixed up. Let's come right up here, right up there. Second number equals txt display dot text, right? Now second number is sorted, so let's append the other data. Let's copy all of this and new line. That's a tab close txt display txt display dot text plus space and space, right? And lbl is three, let's clear that. The text equals LBL is true, that is supposed to be this. We just clear it, because the way it works is if there's data in here, this is cleared. Only when we click on delete all the content in here, then we get back the data. So in that case, let's enter rtb.clear. So if LBL is free display dot text equals nothing, then in that case I want LBL display dot text equals the reasons there's no history yet, right? There's no history yet right in there. Then it's closed anyway. Let's move this up. And the next thing is, let's say btn clear is free, this one dot visible equals false, and rt, I want to get rid of this scroll anyway. Let's say dot scroll equals 0. Yeah. So that should do it. So if I run the program now, let's see. Seven multiplied by five multiplied by two multiplied by two again. You see that, guys? It's adding everything into the memory. By two again. Yeah. And if I clear it, check this out. There we go. You see that, guys? That's fine. It's working the way I want. That's good. Now, one more thing. Then we can call it the end of this program. One more thing. Let's add here. Let's add one tree view. There we go. Right here. I'm going to add my tree view. You see the tree view? The tree view will include all of the menus that we have on the system. Okay, so first thing first, let's go to form load. Inside form load, we'll say tree view dot visible equals false right there. So only this guy can enable tree view. Let's double click on this. So tree view that's visible, that label there equals true. Yeah, so when we click on that, that will enable it. Alright, so for the tree view, let's enhance the whole appearance. In the first place, I want to get rid of that very background color. Maybe, yeah, let's get rid of it, change it to, well, I might as well type it in, button face, right. And I think I should try and get rid of all of this edge. Just come in here and make it none right there. You see, there's nothing there now. Now, the first thing we want to do is, after all of those property sets, let's come in here. You see the nodes? Click on the nodes and add. The first node I intend to add will be calculate. Calculator. Right, add another node. I'm going to create a space in between them. So let's come right in here, get rid of node 1. The first node is node 0, this is node 1, node 2. Here, come in here and just change that to standard. Change this to scientific calculator. Okay, so I will now speed that up now that you guys get the whole idea. Get rid of this. You see, if I click on that, those will appear here. Okay, I will speed it up so that we have enough time. Okay guys, this is how my tree view is looking now. So I'm gonna move it here, that's where I want it to be, and let's run the program first. Let's move it all down. See all of this information, you should see them on the Windows 10 calculator. So I'm gonna run it right there. You see the tree view is gone. So let's see. Okay, this is working fine. Supposing we want to select another form of calculator here. See, that's what this preview is all about. So when I click on it, this changes to that and the calculator should appear. So let's close this. So what we need to do now is get the name of this. Okay, you see that? LBL. Display. So I'm going to double click on the tree view. So anytime we click on it, we will use an if statement. Let's say if e dot node dot name equals node 3. Node 3 is the very first one. I think that might be equals. Then LBL dot dot text equals very first one is standard. Okay. And we also want the tree view itself. Tree view. Dot visible equals false. There. So all we need to do is, you can use else if, or you can just come in here. The next one will be number five, that is scientific. Let's see the next one. This is 3, 5, 7. The next one is 7. Node 7 is programmable. Now let's try it out and see what's gonna happen with those 3. Alright, show our dialog. There we go. Okay, show another one. That's not right. Okay, that is fine. Okay, I think that's wrong. Alright, okay, I'm gonna get it right anyway. Alright, so you guys get the whole idea. I think this one, let's see what node that one is meant to be. Let's see. Let's check this out. Because I changed it while I was working on that. That's 39. It's not 3, it's 39. Alright then. And programmer is 5. Okay, let's go back into our code. Right here, scientific is 39. And this one is 5. Okay, that's brilliant. Let's try it again and we speed it up. Standard is fine. Scientific, there. Programmer, there. Okay. So, like I said, only if I can get 30,000 views and 1,000 like, then I will unfailingly complete the rest of the calculator. But before I call it the end of the day, let's finish up this. Okay guys, I've finished the codes for the tree view just using if statement. You can always use else if, that's fine. That's it. Okay, so have a good look at it. Because I have approximately 39 nodes on board. And that's it. So all we're just doing is listing the menu, whatever menu is selected, display that and display the operation or operators for that menu, and make the menu visible. That's all. So if I run it now, click on standard. Let's say we want to know about the system. Click on about. About is displayed, and that means we're talking about whatever component we have on the system. But I won't be doing that now until I get approximately, not approximately, until I get 30,000 views and 1,000 likes for this very project. As you can see, we have a lot of work to do here. The only one that might follow soon is going to be the temperature, because this temperature will be used for the rest. The format of the temperature will be used for most of the design. So that's it anyway. So with that guys, I'm going to call it the end of this Windows 10 style calculator. So let's try it out again. And there guys, with that I'm going to call it the end of this tutorial. You all have a nice day now. Bye for now. And please do subscribe and like. Bye.